Hello, today we're going to see how to unleash the full potential of a hardware synthesizer by controlling it with your Erae 2. We'll be using the Hydrasynth from ASM, but the setup and routing applies to most of the hardware machines out there. The Erae 2 can control many synthesizers through the USB hosts, MIDI Out A and B ports. Here I connect them using a TRS to MIDI cable going from MIDI Out A on the Erae to the MIDI in port on the Hydrasynth. Once the connection is made, press the settings button, scroll down to the routing menu and activate MIDI A. This will allow us to communicate MIDI data through this port. Then in the Tune tab of my keyboard element, I will toggle MIDI A. There we go, I'm able to control the Hydrasynth. To take advantage of the MPE capabilities of both devices, I'll first go into the Hydrasynth system setup and activate MPE. Then I'll toggle MPE on my keyboard element in the lab. Now I can do things like this. Of course, I can customize the patch. And to do so, I'll go to the mod matrix. For example, amp level is assigned to poly aftertouch by default, but I can change it to white apps, which means that an upward motion after pressing a key will modulate the selected parameter. Nice. Let's say that I want to synchronize the clock of my Hydrasynth with my Erae 2. I'll go back to System Setup, scroll down to page 4, then set the clock sync parameter to MIDI in. On the Erae 2, the default clock source is set to int for internal, which is exactly what I need. Or maybe I can synchronize my Hydrasynth to my DAW through the Erae 2. And in this case, I would go to settings, then clock source, and set it up to USB device. Then in the routing menu, I'd activate USB device towards MIDI A. Thank you for watching this video, and until next time, have fun with your Erae 2.